chops from that draw, should get a lovely run. Just a tricky horse. You know, Boris will soon find out. And I was talking to him about this ride, and he agrees, extravagant action, likes to get the head up, but has the ability. 14, your mums are racing terrifically. No surprise they've come for him. And 3, Yidabar has been the biggest drift you'll ever see, but oh, I think he paraded great. He's $31. I can't believe it. 7, 5, 14, and 3 in the lucky last. The track's been terrific, gone from a heavy 9 to a soft 7. That's played fair as far as a rail out 9 can play. I think they've been anywhere from the fence to about 4 or 5 off. And Robbie Dolan's taken the riding honours with a couple of absolute pearlers early in the day and really does know this track well, even though he's only been here a short time. 7, 5, 14 and 3, the numbers. Damien, you're out tomorrow to Warwick, so you found a $10 winner today that came into 370, and you're already on top of the form for tomorrow, so you'll be out there on STC for all those punters that want Damien's tips tomorrow, so don't miss out on that. There's only one horse left to load, and that's Frappe. Let's head up to Josh to call them home for the last time today. No worries, Alex.
Cyan Star, Master Plan, Yidabar both began well. Your mums are going forward, followed by Hooks on the inside and further back to Pretty Little Lass and trapped out Bambalam. With all the shops out of Stern Villa between them, Cyan Star, Sassy Choice on the outside, followed further back by Golly Hut and Negation, second last but has found the fence there. And 3 wide last of all is Frappe. Swin front Yidabar by 2 lengths, second your mumsa. 2.5 to Master Plan on the inside of Hooks and further back in the field to Pretty Little Lass and Bambalam is out 3 wide but rolling forward, followed by all the shops out of Stern Villa, Cyan Star, Sassy Choice going forward, Frappe. Negation second last on the fence and Golly Hut's last of all at the 550. Yidabar just in front from Hooks and Bambalam is out wide on the track as they swing around the home turn. Your mums are right up there as well. Master Plan, Pretty Little Lass, one from the outside. Running home as a Stern Villa and Frappe's is out wider at the 350 across the track. It's now Hooks in front from Bambalam. Pretty Little Lass is coming through. Your mums are on the inside of Stern Villa and Negation gets out last and runs home, but Pretty Little Lass has shot through and taken over near the line. Pretty Little Lass has won it from either Bambalam or Negation, followed by a Stern Villa. Your mums are Hooks and not far away Golly Hut, followed by Cyan Star, all the shops, Frappe's, Master Plan, Sassy Choice and Yidabar. Great ride from Sean Cormack there.
Lass has landed a few bets there, 8 into 7. Lovely ride by Sean Cormack. Used the good gate, popped off at the fence just when he wanted to, and held off the late finish of Bambalam at a big price. And Negation, Jasper Franklin, lovely ride, got back, threaded the needle, had to probably get a little bit wider than he wanted to late, but has hit the line full of running, and a win won't be too far away there. The 16 Aston Villa has wound up in fourth. That's a pretty close go for second, but the numbers not in the frame yet, so we'll just wait for that second and third to become official. But the 13, no doubt about the winner, Pretty Little Lass. Close go for second, 19 or 7, and the 16 Aston Villa back in third. The pace was on, set by Yidabar, and Yidabar's knocked up in the straight. You can see them there coming from everywhere down the straight, but Pretty Little Lass, too good. Paul Jenkins, he's having a good run at the moment, Paul, and the local trainers take home the last. Still no numbers in the frame. We've got the time, 1:19.94, and the last 600 was 36:09, but we will just wait. Here they come now. So the 13's definitely got it, Pretty Little Lass. The 19, Bambalam, will get second for Pat Duff and Casey Waddell, and that'll leave the 7, Negation, for third, unless we're hearing something different. So we'll just wait for those numbers to come into the frame at this stage, 13 and 19. So we'll wait and see what happens there. Damien's gone to find an interview. Number 7 in the frame now for third, Negation. And now we just need the fourth number, which I assume will be the 16, Aston Villa. But the 13, a Pretty Little Lass. She's won start win 3 at start number 28. So she's taken a while. It's about 697 days since she last saluted, and her best run lately was a third here behind Dubai Pride. But well ridden, Sean Cormack. Nice gate, makes a difference. Here are the numbers: 13 19 7 16. 13 19 7 and 16. Damien, you found a stable rep.
We've got part owner Brian Artist here, and firstly congratulations, because it's been a long time between drinks for this horse. Tell us about the story of this horse.
Well originally from Melbourne, and we got a lot of happy owners involved, and it's been a long drawn out process. She's been hard work from the day dot, you know, but Paul's done a fantastic job with her.
last couple of runs, she's been putting the writing on the wall, hasn't she? Going to do it. I'm assuming she's had a few little hiccups along the way.
A few issues, but she's, you know, she's. We knew she had ability. It was just getting picking the right race and, you know, giving us some confidence. I think today might be the turning point for us.
It must be a very exciting win for you, because when you invest into a horse and you've got to wait so long and things can go wrong for you, you've got to enjoy the win when it comes.
Absolutely, mate, and we will. Yeah. We will. We always do. They're, you know, with adrenaline, they're a great bunch of blokes that organise it, and it's been good fun so far.
Let's hope there's more installed now. She's broken through for that win. Well done, Brian.
Thanks very much, mate. Okay. Thank you.
Brian Artis, part owner of this horse. And as we mentioned, Paul, they've all been very, very, very patient people. But she's been racing well. And as you mentioned, Paul, the Jenkins stable, they're going well at the moment, getting winners at the country and provincial tracks. And it's good to see for the stable. He's a great fellow, Paul, and does a good job with his horses. They always present well. And he deserves the wins when they come, because he has to be pretty patient with them. I know Tony Two's one that's racing really well at the moment, and she needed just a little bit of time to break through for that win, and she's done that, and she's racing well at the moment also. So we're about to have a chat to Sean Cormack just before we sign off here. He's jumped in to give the owners a bit of a run through, but we'll have a chat with him shortly. Bamberland putting plenty of value if you're taking trifectas and first fours there. Good luck to you, because Bamberland at $10 the place has run a mighty race, and Negation was a very good third. But as Paul mentioned, they were right across the track there at the 200 metre mark, but this mare was very strong at the end. So let's see if we can pop in now and have a quick chat to Sean. Sean, very quickly, mate, well done. Yeah. Take us through the race. She was good the last 200.
Yeah, I was just saying to the owners that she probably relished being sort of cuddled till late. I just waited for the gap to open. I knew one or two of them would tire and start to wander around. So I was just going to wait for the run until it opened. And if it didn't, I'd take my punishment. But I had a lot of horse. So when the gap opened, she sprinted through nicely. I think if I'd peeled it out and taken her wide, I think it might have been her undoing. She really, really has been cuddled away today.
Yeah. Okay, and for horses like this, you've got to ride them sometimes for luck to get the results.
Yeah, exactly, and on top of that, a good gait helps, you know. But full marks to Paul in the yard, you know, they've had her going a couple of weeks now, and she probably raced her best today.
Great ride, mate. Well done.
Thank you.
Sean Cormack there. That takes us away, Paul, after race seven.
Yes, it does, Damien. Thanks for your help today and your company. Thanks for everyone who's tuned in throughout the afternoon. And, of course, all the team at Sky Channel, whether they're back in Sydney or here on course, for bringing everyone the pictures today. But we'll sign off for the afternoon. Formline Extra on the back of this very short break.